Hey everybody, Coach Dan here. So I was just finishing up my workout and I was having one of those days, and I thought it would be good to kind of share with you what I was dealing with. This is completely unscripted. As you can tell, I'm a little sweaty, a little out of breath. Just gonna kind of roll with it, so I hope you'll bear with me. I'm sure I'll have some trouble talking about stuff, but that's okay. So I wanted to talk about, you know, as a 57-year-old guy, what it's like trying to train sometimes, okay? So, you know, if you watch the channel, you know that I'm a trainer, along with my wife. And, you know, everybody seems to think that trainers, we're always motivated, all right? We always have awesome workouts. We always have great days, that kind of thing. And let me tell you, nothing could be further from the truth. Nothing, okay? We have our good days, yes. We have our bad days. We have days we're super motivated. We have days, like today for me, where we don't want to do it, all right? I did not want to work out today, okay? And that's okay when those happen, but you've got to kind of figure out how you want to approach it. And for me, at least today, you know, and I thought about skipping today. I could have always done it tomorrow, but I have a lot going on. So the odds of me getting it done tomorrow probably were pretty slim. So I said, I'm gonna get through it, okay? And I've talked about this in the newsletter I write sometimes too, but not too long ago I had written how, you know, when you have a day like that, or a day like I'm having today, to just commit to doing one set of one exercise. And that's kind of what I did here, all right? So my planned workout was to do squats, overhead press, deadlifts, and then I had some ancillary work, some calf raises, and some bicep curls. So I committed at least at first to try and get the overhead press done because it's one of the ones I wanted to work on. Well, lo and behold, I got through the entire thing, and I'm rolling some film of me doing some of these exercises, because one of the things I also do when I'm having a bad day is I watch my form. So I videoed it, and if you're watching it and you know about form, you know that I am anal about it, and so I'm going to be self-critiquing my form later on. That's why I videoed it, and I'll be honest with you, there are some form slips in there and a couple really bad ones, and that's okay too, all right? You're not going to get better if you don't analyze what you're doing wrong and fix it. Now, you know, kind of just step back, and one of the things I think that as a, you know, a mid-50s guy, and this applies to the ladies too, but one of the things I think we forget is that we are in our mid-50s, okay? You know, I talk about this a lot too, where, you know, I remember what I could do at 17 and 27 and 37 and even 47. At 57, I can't do some of the same things I did back then. And I know that here, but I think I don't know it here, okay? My heart says I should be able to do what I did at 17. And it messes with my mind, all right? So, you know, one of the things that I like to talk about with people as they get older is kind of resetting the mindset, all right? And focusing on when you have bad days or you're tired, kind of how you should go about it, maybe some changes that you need to make. You know, when I was, I've been training 40 years, four decades now. When I was training people, you know, when I was 20 years old, and I did train some 50-year-olds back then, and, you know, I didn't know, how could I, what it was like to be 50 plus years old, okay? There's no way I could have known that. Yeah, you can read it in a book, absolutely you can. You know, some of the trainers I teach and mentor, I have this conversation with them, and they're like, yeah, but I can study that. You can, I'm not saying you can't, but you don't know how it feels. And, you know, that's one of the things I stress with people, and trainers too, is that, you know, you may not know how it is, you need to listen to people. And in this particular case where I'm going with it is, you need to listen to your body, you need to listen to yourself. And that's what I was doing today also. You know, I had a pretty crappy night's sleep. Probably got a max three and a half, four hours, somewhere in there. And I'll be honest, didn't eat the best yesterday either, okay? And that showed up today. So I know why the day was kind of off. Dealing with a little stress too, and that's okay. Who isn't, right? So what I could have done, as I said earlier, was I could have just decided not to do the workout, but that wouldn't get me where I want to be with my goals, okay? So I adapted it. So instead of doing all of the sets that I had planned, I cut them in half. So I had planned originally to do 6 sets of the various exercises, and I was doing anywhere from 3 to 6 reps of each set, vary depending on the exercise. Well, I just cut it to 3 and 3. So I did 3 sets of 3 for everything. Now, I know some of you might sit there and go, but that's not enough work. It's not what I planned, but it's plenty of work. It's plenty of work for me today, and I'm good with that, okay? And then, you know, the other thing to kind of think about as you're, while we're on the topic, as you're getting older, is getting more rest in between your workouts. So, you know, common thing people will think that I, as a trainer, do is that I work out every day. Now, when I was 17, even when I was 27, yeah, that was true, okay? When I was in my mid-30s and mid-40s, I had a family, but I still got to the gym fairly regularly. Some weeks it was 4, some weeks it was 5, occasionally be 6, really rarely 7, but, you know, I cut back. Now, for me, if I tried to work out 6 to 7 days a week, it wouldn't work. My body needs more time to recover. Truth be told, I only work out hard 3 times a week. Generally, it's Monday, Wednesday, Friday. I give myself at least a full day in between my workouts and 2 days on the weekend. You know, and occasionally I get thrown off and I can't get a workout in, and then I can do it the next day, and then I adapt the schedule, because I always make sure, especially with my strength training and the weightlifting, that I have at least 1 full day between. And generally I do my workouts in the morning, so by the time I finish a workout and start the next one, it's almost 2 full days, okay? That's an adaptation I've had to make as I get older, and it's something that you need to consider as you get older, okay? Going super hard every single day, that's what leads to injuries, it leads to long-term fatigue. Your body will just plain wear down, guys and girls, okay? The other thing to think about is not just rest days, but rest time between sets. So, depending on my workout, and I'll use today as an example, I was resting 5 minutes between sets. So it took me a while to get my workout done, but that's what I needed to do today, all right? Even though I was doing only 3 sets of 3 for each exercise, I was resting 5 minutes between those sets. As opposed to what I normally rest, again, it depends on the exercise, but I generally 2.5 to 3, maybe 3.5 minutes between sets. So I extended the rest, give my body more time to recoup. It's what I needed to do today. And that's where I'm going with it, guys, is you still want to progress on things, you still want to work out, you still want to push your body a little bit, but you also have to listen to it. And when the day comes, like mine today, you need to pull back. It's okay. And a lot of people really struggle with that. You know, we're not the spring chickens we were in our teens. And, you know, a lot of people think just push through, power through, muscle through, all different things. And I hear younger trainers say that all the time. And, you know, they just don't get it. And I'm not trying to fault them in any way. They just don't understand it, okay? So it's okay to make changes. It's okay to adapt your workouts. It's okay to make changes week to week, day to day, whatever it might be. Listen to your body, all right? Listen to it. It's telling you what it needs. And, you know, if it comes down to it that you actually do need to skip the workout, you just need more rest, sometimes that's gonna happen too. And again, that's okay. All right, I just thought I'd share these thoughts kind of just off my brain, off the top of my head. Hopefully you enjoyed it. If you did, do me a favor, hit that like button below. And, you know, feel free to share this, guys, because we're trying to spread the word and help as many people as we can. You know, with our channel, Lori and I focus on over 50, but a lot of what we talk about applies to any age group, okay? And the other thing I would recommend you do is hit that subscribe button below and ring the notification bell, because that way you'll know when we're releasing a video, and we can share our wisdom with you. All right. Thank you for joining me today. I hope you have an awesome day. Until next time. Bye.